Do we seek to be humble and simple of heart like Jesus Christ? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God. Every day, amen.
Saint Faustina Kowalska was born August 25, 1905. In Poland, to Mariana and Stanislaw Kowalski, humble peasants but fervent Christians. Baptized Helena, Faustina was the third of 10 children. She left school after 3 years and began working as a domestic in several wealthy households to support her family. At 20, driven by a vision of the suffering Christ, who said to her, "How long will I have to bear you?" As long as you trick me, she decided to enter religious life. On August 10, 1925, she entered the convent of the Sisters of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mercy in Warsaw and took the name Sister Maria Faustina. She spent 13 years of religious life in various convents of the congregation, working as a cook, gardener, and porter. The Lord gave her abundant graces, of which his stigmata were the most visible. She also received numerous revelations and visions that, as suggested by her confessors, she recorded in her diary. On February 22, 1931, dressed in white, our Lord Jesus appeared to Saint Faustina. He had a hand raised to bless, while the other touched his chest. The slightly open border of his robe let out two great rays, one red, the other pale. Jesus said to her, "Paint an image according to the model you see," with these words written, "Jesus, I trust in you." "I wish this image to be venerated first in your chapel and then in the whole world." The image was eventually painted. The Feast of Divine Mercy, on the first Sunday after Easter, the Divine Mercy Chaplet, and the prayer at the hour of mercy would later on inspire great devotion. Saint Faustina died of tuberculosis on October 5, 1938 in Krakow at 33. In the 1960s, then Archbishop of Krakow, Karol Wojtyla, promoted her life and virtues. As Pope John Paul II, he proclaimed her blessed on April 18, 1993, and a saint on April 30, 2000, announcing on the same date that the establishment of the Sunday of Divine Mercy. It was also on the eve of this feast, on April 2, 2005, that Pope John Paul II passed on and reached the house of our Heavenly Father. Saint Faustina was among the patrons of the Jubilee of Mercy, proclaimed by Pope Francis. The 72 disciples returned and said to Jesus, "Lord, even the demons are subject to us because of your name." At that very moment, he rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, "I give you praise, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will." Do we know the joy of the Lord? The Scriptures tells us that we can only draw strength from the love and joy of the Lord. God always assures us of victory in Jesus Christ, regardless of circumstances, in good times and in bad, in successes and losses. Jesus Christ became like us to conquer the powers of darkness and sin. And like Saint Faustina, we as disciples of Christ had been given spiritual authority to overcome evil with good. Our Lord Jesus Christ desires that we be like childlike in character, simple and humble of heart, totally dependent and trusting in the summum bonum, or greatest good, who is God Himself. Humility, the queen of virtues, inclines us to God and disposes us to receive God's wisdom. Nothing can give us greater joy than the knowledge that we are God's beloved and that our names are written in heaven. Do we seek to be humble and simple of heart like Jesus Christ? Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, stretch out upon the cross. Give us the grace of faithfully following the most holy will of your Father in all things, always and everywhere. And when this will of God seems to us very harsh and difficult to fulfill, it is then we beg you, Jesus, may power and strength flow upon us from your wounds, and may our lips keep repeating, your will be done, all. Jesus, King of mercy, we trust in you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers, and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and Couples for Christ.